Hello, my name is David Naon. I work at Dassault Systèmes in the Passion for Innovation Institute. And in my team, the Ivy Lab, we are studying immersive user experiences and strictly focuses on that topic.
In this video, we intend to share our findings in building 3D experiences with immersive VR headsets. The general public tends to associate VR with those new consumer devices. But in the industry, professionals mostly use immersive rooms called caves. In such spaces, the user is surrounded by 3D projected images and wears glasses that are being tracked in the room, letting him walk around virtual 3D objects and discuss with colleagues. Unfortunately, their diffusion towards consumers remains limited because they are costly and take up a lot of space. VR headsets have not penetrated the consumer markets either due to their lack of immersivity and lack of actual content. Hopefully, with this new generation of headsets, consumer VR is likely to enter, at last, everybody's home. But those devices are not offering all what a cave offers. The main issues being to isolate the user from his own body, have him lose contact with other people and with the real world. To counter this negative aspect, we have explored ways to add some items of the reality in the virtuality. We started by attaching to an Oculus Rift either a leap motion or a soft kinetic camera. We finally developed an experience combining an Oculus DK1 and a fixed Kinect for Windows 2.
We're now in the Ivy Lab. I'm going to show you what we think could be a good solution to get all the benefits that you have in a cave, but with a much more simple equipment and more affordable. So we have a Kinect for Windows over here, and if I wave at it, it tracks me, and I have, when I move, this nice motion parallax, okay? And now I have an Oculus Rift, okay, and a pad. So first, what you can see here is that I see my own hands. I can also look at my own body. These are my own feet. So now that you've seen the first person view, let's switch just for you to have a better view to a third person view, and you will get a great understanding of what's happening. You see me in this port, and I'm looking around, and you understand what I'm doing. Now imagine I'm a little bit lost. I want to be sure that I'm not going to hit an obstacle or whatever. I can just switch to the 3D view, and as you can see, I have my surrounding, my physical surrounding. So this pod here, I can see and touch. This chair here, it's there. So I can just sit on it and I'm safe, no problem. I can also have interaction with other elements of reality. So maybe if someone came around me, hey Jeff.
Hey.
Hey, how'd you do? You can see that we're in the same physical world. I can see Geoffrey. If we switch to first person, I can see him like this. And so I know he's dressed in black, he's got a white paper in the left hand. And still, I mean, I'm immersed in this virtual world, but we're still in the same physical world and we can interact. At some stage, I would like to know where I am. I don't want to hit an obstacle or whatever. So I can selectively just display my near surrounding, the thing I look at. And for instance, let's check over there. Oh, hey, nice feature. You see that? This is a real thing in reality, and it suddenly appeared because it's close to me and it's in red. So that's a nice way to detect that there is something in reality that I don't want to hit.
To conclude, our experience allows the user to see his own body, perceive the real surrounding and interact with it, as well as have social interactions with other people in the room. We are convinced that compelling user experiences with VR headsets need to take into account the real physical world. Our tests have confirmed that the presence of your tool and the comfort of the user can easily be greatly improved. Thanks for watching.